Hello everybody, I'm Alfred, and the video I'm about to check out is the movie trailer for Interceptor, so let's check it out. Okay, so already we see that this is a female lead, you know, when it comes to the heroine, the action hero wing stuff, but you know what I noticed is that she actually is true to form when it comes to it being realistic. You know, it goes to that feel of the original Terminator 2, you know, where Sarah Connor was, you know, became kind of like an action heroine. You know, she went from running away from the Terminator to becoming tough and all of that, so it has that realisticness to it, you know. So even though it's still in line with wokeness and, you know, quota systems, because, you know, it is clear, you know, like for example the LGBT crowd has given Hollywood a mandate that over 60%, you know, or 70% of their main characters should be gay, you know, and LGBT or whatever. And of course, you know what happened with Disney, and you know the internal video that was spread where the Disney executive was saying that she's going to make sure that, you know, over half of the lead characters in the cartoons and the movies by Disney for children are going to feature gay, transgender and all that kind of nonsense. You know, they have that mandate, so there is that quota system of, oh, you have to put this number of female leads, you have to put this number of gay characters and all of that, you know. So that explains this. Of course, this fits into programming the mind, because this is basically mass programming, you know, for a larger scale, you know, for something bigger, but it is done in little ingredients under the cause of, oh, we are empowering women, or we are doing something, just like aborting children is looked upon as women empowerment. Oh, we are giving women the right to do what they want with their body. But the issue is that the body inside their body is not their body. You know, the woman had the right to do what she wanted to do with her body when she could either close her legs or open her legs. She chose to open her legs, you know, and not use any protection, and, you know, sleep around. She gets pregnant, and then she now wants to abort the baby, you know. That's crazy. That is murder, you know. So it is what it is. So we see, in any case, this quota system, you know, it's like, oh, let us make women stop being the damsel in distress. You know, let it not be the woman being saved, let the woman be the heroine. But by doing that, they are doing two things. First of all, they are making women masculine, and that is what they are promoting, the image of a woman being masculine, you know, a woman being the hero, the tough guy, beating people and all of that, you know, being the place of the hero. And then you are programming men, you know, against the natural instinct of protecting women. You know, you have now made it wrong for a man to protect a woman, because it's like, oh, you're trying to, you're being sexist, and you know, you're saying that women cannot protect themselves and women cannot help themselves and all of that. You know, you're trying to say that women are helpless, you know. So there's that push of it. So all of this, you know, has a greater purpose and a big picture for setting in place a new world order, you know, which is not going to work out for the interest of anybody who believes in freedom or in peace, basically.
Navy runs the boat. Army handles the missiles.
Captain Collins reporting, sir.
Everyone wants to be
and of course she's an immigrant, you know, you can get that from the accent. So you see that propaganda also, you know. It's so unfortunate that people don't see how dangerous it is that leftist propaganda and wokeness is all over the Hollywood movies, it's all over the schools. And this is why I keep emphasizing the importance of Christians taking over positions of authority and power. I know what I'm saying, because these positions are in the hands of evil people that have evil intentions and long-term goals. They are intentionally resp- planning and they are responsible for a lot of the chaos. Look at Bill Gates. Bill Gates planned this pandemic. This the recent one that we just saw with the COVID, you know, Bill Gates planned it. You know, there's a video of him talking about it, you know, about preparing for a pandemic and all of that. You know, this is somebody that after he retired from Microsoft, he has put his money, you know, and so much into creating an organization for vaccines. And you know, his plan is to vaccinate the whole world and keep the whole world vaccinated. And this is part of the problem with people who don't believe in God. When people don't believe in God, they are just a blank slate for Satan to use, manipulate, enter, possess, and do all kinds of nonsense. You know, here you see how even in this situation where people have been vaxxed once, twice, 30, so many times, you know, 4 times, they are still getting the virus, but they are still believing in the vax and are telling people to take the vax. What kind of nonsense is that? And you see situations where, you know, they have gone against natural immunity. It's not about natural immunity. If you have gotten the virus before and your body has you've recovered from it, that means that your body has created naturally antibodies that have made you immune to it. That is a fact, you know, and that has been scientific fact previously, but now it is no longer scientific fact. It is now like whether you have gotten it before, all of you must take the vax, you know. But we thank God that thanks to prayer and all of that have died down. But there are still those who want to bring it up. But we pray, and it is not enough to pray, we must take action. You see, this is why I keep emphasizing about the Christians having their power and their impact felt upon politicians. Christians apply no pressure to politicians. The LGBT and all these other groups, they apply pressure to politicians. Politicians look out to, oh, let me impress this group so that they will vote for me. Oh, let me impress the homosexuals so that the homosexuals will vote for me. But nobody cares about Christians. You know, in spite of the fact they are made, because the Christians themselves don't care about these things. They have believed lies of the devil and lies of infiltrators who are in the clergy, who are pastors, who are bishops, you know, who are, you know, for example, the Pope, you know. They believe those kinds of people who don't love God and who are basically agents of the devil, you know. So, in spite of the number of Christians around the world, we are so persecuted and we do nothing about it, and the persecution keeps rising, and the places where Christianity is allowed keeps decreasing. Oh, Christianity is not allowed in schools. Where are the Christians that are standing up fighting against it legally, you know, or even praying about it? Christians have adjusted and accommodated it, but LGBT is being taught in schools. Now they are fighting for it being taught to children. You know, they are fighting for it being taught, you know, look at Disney and all these companies, fighting for it to be taught to children, fighting for the indoctrination of children into LGBT, into, oh, a man can be born into a woman's body, oh, a man can marry a man, oh, a woman can marry a woman, oh, being a man is not about what is on your birth certificate, it's based on how you feel, you know, all kinds of nonsense. There are people who are now, you know, in certain states in America, now creating binary birth certificates. So in the birth certificate, the person can choose neither male nor female. If you are not male or female, what are you? You know, you can't start creating your own genders. But this is what these people, you know, have bought into because of certain lobbyist groups who have pushed their agenda. Why aren't Christians who have been given the mission to preach the gospel? Why aren't we pushing? We've left all the missions to the devil. The only person that is being an evangelist right now, the people who are taking evangelism serious are the gay people, the LGBT, are the Satanists, you know, are the woke people. Those are the ones that are taking evangelism serious into every look and cranny of society. They want their mentality and their way of thinking to dominate everywhere. And they are pushing hard for it. Yet Christians, you know, what are we doing?
Anywhere but here. We're the only interceptor platform protecting from a nuclear missile attack. We have a situation.
Unauthorized missile removal.
What the hell's going on up there?
We are under attack!
up for this.
Don't worry about me, sir.
Interceptor, what is your status?
7 terrorists seized our vessel.
And of course, this is very unrealistic. They have put the female as the lead over all these men and in an action scenario. Let's understand something. This is how feminism is a weapon for destruction of you know, the nations that accept it. You know, we must recognize feminism for what it is now. It is demonic and it's satanic, and it's something that flows very well with, you know, the mother of harlots. There's a reason why that term was used in the book of Revelation, the mother of harlots. You know, a shift of putting the woman in authority. The woman should not be on top of the man. This is a reality. You know, you have to understand structure. And part of the big problem with Adam is that he put his wife on top of him. He puts Eve on top of him. As a matter of fact, so him even listening to the snake, what business does he have being taught by a snake? That he was above every animal and above the woman, and the woman told him this. You know, he should have, as a man, no, we are not doing this. You know, he should have taken charge. You know, when men step away from their role in the name of certain things that sound good, nonsense ensues. You know, and now when it comes to this movie that is pushing feminism and the unrealisticness of this foolishness, you know, putting the woman in charge of a military operation and in this action situation, the fact remains that women are biologically softer than men. You know, they are the weaker sex, and that is the fact. Women are the weaker sex, you know. So putting them in this situation, when you look at the military, you know, the American military has basically been destroyed, you know, thanks to LGBT and feminism. You know, there are people who are using the taxpayer dollars to turn military personnel into transgenders. And then they are now also reducing the standards of training so that women can get higher positions and get into certain divisions and positions in the army that no woman has attained before. And they will, of course, celebrate it. Oh, this is the first woman to be in this position. But they decreased the training standards. But other nations are not doing the same. Other nations are increasing their training standards and are getting tougher. You know, they are not falling into this foolishness. Now, of course, they are teaching people all this stupidity, you know, putting this mindset out there to create an idea like, oh, anything a man can do physically, a woman can also do physically. No, we are built different, you know.
And they tried to take the command center.
I have contained or killed everyone else on this vessel. And we control 16 nuclear missiles. I need to disable your command center, so I will be getting into that room.
You want this room? Come and get it. We don't have time to evacuate cities.
Hold that room.
Did you just stab that dude in the eye with your gun?
I'm the one in charge.
You want to get out of here alive. Not going so well for you, is it?
And of course, making the woman the tough, the you see, this now is a switch of roles. You know, the woman is tough and she's now encouraging them. The army, the other members of her team are now the soft ones, are now the damsel in distress. Basically, the men are the damsel in distress and the woman is now the masculine one. So the men are feminine and the woman is masculine. Remember that the Bible makes it clear that heaven, you know, the kingdom of God is not for the effeminate. You know, men cannot be effeminate, you know, and effeminate, you know, goes beyond just homosexual. You know, it's different from homosexual. A homosexual, you know, somebody that has sexual intercourse with somebody that is the same sex as they are. You know, it is not something that people are born as. You know, you are not a homosexual, you know, because you think you are or because you are told you are. You actually have to commit the act, because according to the Bible and in reality, you know, it is an act. It is not who you are. It is nobody's identity. So you cannot say that a child is gay or a child is homosexual. There's no such thing. Unless, of course, the child has committed the act, then that brings to question what kind of parent are you, or what kind of adult are you, you know, that creates that environment for children to, you know, be having sex, you know, as, you know, 12-year-old, you know, like, you know, Dwayne Wade Johnson, whose son, you know, came out and said that, you know, that he's a woman trapped in a man's body, and they are, and his parents are helping, you know, specifically his father, not the mother, because the mother apparently has, for whatever reason, lost all rights over her own son. And which is another thing about the government and, you know, laws that we should fight. For example, in Canada right now, if a child says that, you know, after going to school and they have indoctrinated that child, and that child says that, you know, they want to swap genders and they want to take puberty blockers, you know, and they want to, you know, change from one sex to another, if the parent says no, that child will be taken away from the parents. And that's a new law that have been put in Canada. You see, this is why I keep emphasizing the importance of fighting, you know, Christians being politically active and, you know, going into positions of political authority. These things are in place. You know, the Bible talks about persecution of Christians. Are you waiting for that time? We already see the little signs. You know, right now they are already making so many things illegal and impossible. You know, so it is unfortunate. In that kind of scenario, basically the government is the owner of your children, because the government decides how you train your child. Otherwise, they will take the child away from you under the topic of child abuse. So now it is now child abuse to say that, to tell your child that no, you know, a man is a man and a woman is a woman. You know, and keep in mind, in the case of Dwayne Wade Johnson, you know, Dwayne Wade, you know, the information that you know, has come out, you know, in addition to what we previously knew, you know, we didn't even know that it was from the teacher. You know, Dwayne Wade said that it was his teacher that helped his son come out. So you mean to tell me that if his son was in a Christian school, or if his son was under a teacher that was not interested in indoctrination, that would have never happened. You know, children are susceptible. You know, what you tell them is what they'll believe. You tell a child about Santa Claus, they'll believe. You tell a child that elephants can fly, they will believe. You know, so children at that early age, you know, you can tell them anything, you can sell them anything. You know, so it's very unfortunate that Satan has gone ahead and is selling so much nonsense, and the saints of God are doing nothing about it.
You plan for every possible outcome, but you couldn't plan for me.
This is so stupid, and this is going to help to create a world where later, when we live in a world where women are asking for why don't men protect us, you know, and all of that, you know, you have yourself to blame. Just like the women who are asking now, why don't men approach them? Why would they, when you call any man approaching you, you know, sexual assault, you know, and rape? You know, the word rape is now tossed about so much that everything now is rape. So this is very unfortunate. You know, that being said, every movie is best told from a Christian perspective. If you are listening to this and you like to be a part of taking the entertainment industry with the gospel, reach out to us on alfred.vip. We'll be happy to hear from you. Now, if you're a pastor, you are a minister of the gospel, you know, for you have a church, you know, your drama department, you know, that is your movie company, you know, your choir, that is your music company. Create celebrities from inside the church, you know, create, you know, a company, a music company, a movie company, you know, let the drama department, you know, you can start with making shorts, you know, you can even make stage plays, you know, make sitcoms, you know, on, you have that, you know, the church building, the altar, on any day that perhaps is not a service day, you know, they show up, you do some shooting, you know, create stuff, you know, reach out to this world, reach out to this generation in things that will appeal to this generation. A lot of people in this generation are not going to put on a sermon. For example, there are Muslim TV channels. Have you ever switched the channel one day when you were channel surfing as a Christian? You know, you went to a Muslim TV channel and then you started listening to the imam speak. No. So what makes you think that many people, you know, who come from other places or other worlds of faith, you know, will be flipping by a TV channel and see a preacher and want to listen? You know, it takes the anointing and the grace of God. The fact that that has been happening and people have been won to Christ that way is a miracle. You know, but we have to be smart. You know, these Muslims, they watch movies, they listen to music. You know, atheists watch movies, listen to movies. These are opportunities for us to reach out to them. The gays and the LGBT, that is why they are emphasizing, oh, Hollywood, over 60%, 70% of your characters must be gay. They understand the impact of that. They are using it to change the mind and the mindsets of people, to make people more, not just open to it, but to participate in it. So the number of people who are involved in LGBT activities will increase from 1% to 5% to 10% to 20%. That is their goal, until it becomes big. Because when you flood people, you know, what you put into people's minds is what is going to come out. When it is flooded into people's mind, this is normal, this is normal, this is normal, try it yourself, try it yourself, try it yourself. That is the goal. You know, Satan knows what he's doing through his children, so we must be smart, you know, and make sure that we stop the devil in his tracks. Thank you and God bless you. If you haven't given your life to Christ, I would like you to say this prayer after me. And don't pray in your mind. Don't repeat these words in your mind. Make sure they come out of your mouth. You don't have to shout, but you have to be able to hear yourself. And make sure you mean every word of it with your heart. Now repeat this prayer after me. Dear God, I come to you in the name of Jesus. Your word says that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, according to Acts 2:21. So now I call upon the name of Jesus, and I ask that you save me. I ask Jesus to come into my heart, to be the Lord of my life. I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I believe he came, died, and rose from the dead to set me free from sin and to reconcile me with you. Your word says that you would freely give the Holy Spirit to all those who ask, according to Luke 11:13. Therefore, I ask that you give me your Holy Spirit to live in me, and as I've asked, I've also received by faith. I thank you, Father, for your precious gifts. I thank you for I have received eternal life. I thank you because I am now saved. I am now born again. I am now one of your kids. In Jesus' name, amen. If you just prayed that prayer, congratulations. Welcome to the family of God. You are now a believer in Christ Jesus. Now, I would like you to go to alfred.vip. Click the Salvation Prayer link in the main menu. At the bottom of the page, you will see some links to some resources that will help you now that you are born again. There are things you need to know about Christianity. There are things that you need to learn. You know, resources that will help you as you begin your walk with God. Thank you and God bless you.